Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean the Fogcrawler.
Hi, I'm Joni. If this is your first visit to the OCIC channel, welcome. If you are a repeat visitor, we hope that you will also be a subscriber. You can go and do the subscription now, and if you click on it, you'll have the option to be notified by hitting the bell whenever we launch a new video, which we hope you will become a subscriber. Our goal is to become verified and hit 100,000 subscribers.
We used to be verified, but YouTube increased the subscriber count from 10,000 to 100,000. We're a little over halfway. We could sure use the push. Today, we're going to be showing you how to make your favorite pizza. We'll show you the basic foundations and let you pick the toppings. Stay tuned. The dough for your favorite pizza gets made the day before baking it. We highly recommend King Arthur's high gluten flour. I'll put a link in the resources. So you start off with 2.5 cups of chilled flour. Packet of instant yeast and a teaspoon of salt. You mix this up till it's evenly combined. Then you're going to add 1 cup of ice water. Now the recipe calls for 1/4 cup of olive oil, but we only use 1/2 of that in the dough. We reserve the other 1/2 for brushing the edges of the pizza right before we bake it. Now we're going to stir this up with a spoon for a few minutes. Get a little flour on my hand, and now we can start forming the dough ball. Okay, we're going to place this in this bowl, and now this goes back in the ice chest. You're probably wondering why we didn't put any sugar in to activate the yeast. Well, this is going to ferment overnight in the ice chest and form natural sugars to start the yeast. See you tomorrow. I have 3 different setups that I can use today to bake the pizza. First one is a standard 14-inch camp oven by Lodge. The second one is a 14-inch camp pizza oven made in America by my friend George Boyette. It's very heavy, very thick-walled. Once you get this baby up to temperature, it's going to hold the heat very well. Good one to use if you're making a lot of pizzas. The next one is kind of a fun one that we came up with. It's basically 2 camp oven lids, one inverted on top of a lid inverter. You got a steel ring in the center, and the other lid goes on top. This came about back in my days with IDOS, I-D-O-S, International Dutch Oven Society. In our lengthy discussions, we joked about starting a new international society called IDOLS, IDOLS, International Dutch Oven Lid Society. We had a lot of fun with that. But my choice and my favorite way is the standard camp oven. I've dusted my cutting board with semolina flour, and now I can take that dough from yesterday out, and we can start rolling our dough. This top side is what's actually going to be the bottom of the dough. And so what I'm going to do is sprinkle some coarse cornmeal on here. And I've pre-cut a piece of parchment paper that's a little bit larger than the pizza skin. And believe it or not, this is about the only thing I use parchment paper for, and you'll see why in a moment. The next thing to do is you want to dock this dough. And what this does is if you get any air bubbles, it won't bubble up and push all your cheese off to one side. You don't need a dough docker. You can just use a regular fork to dock your dough. Now we're going to transfer this to the oven. Okay, here's why I use the parchment paper. I intentionally selected a circle a little bit larger than the inside bottom of this oven so that I would have a raised lip around the edge, kind of like a tray for more cheese. Remember that olive oil we had in reserve? So what we're going to do is we're going to take and just brush that along the edges here. And now we can start assembling my favorite pizza. I do have some prep work to do. My favorite pizza, believe it or not, is just a basic salami and cheese. So I've got to slice some salami up and I got to crumble some Parmesan cheese. So now it's time to put on your favorite pizza sauce. I'm using Contadina pizza squeeze. It's really good and it's very handy. Just give that a quick brushing. Now I'm going to put down a pound of mozzarella. And I've saved a little bit in reserve for stitching. We'll talk about that in a moment. So now I can lay down my salami. I like my salami thick cut. Next, I want to put a little bit of Italian seasoning on here. Now we're going to stitch the salami down with just a little bit of mozzarella. You don't want to cover it up, you just want to overlap it slightly Then we're just going to add a little bit of cheddar, just basically for color and contrast. And the Parmesan you can either put on now or you can put on right after the pizza is baked. So now we're going to bake this hot and fast. Okay, one thing before we throw this heat at it, this lid's going to be completely covered with briquettes. So I'm going to give it a wipe down of oil inside and out. This will help protect the seasoning a little bit. We're going to bake this for 18 minutes. We've had just the slightest breeze come up, so we've put our windshield up. Let's check this and see how it's doing. It's looking good. I think I want it just a little bit more brown. With that breeze, we let it go an extra 5 minutes. So let's see how she looks. I'm happy. Now we're going to remove it from the heat. Let it sit for a moment before we retrieve it. I've got this one leg propped up on my coal shovel. I got to get this pizza peel in down around that wall. So you got to kind of do it all in one motion. Look at that. That's a thing of beauty. And here's pizza number two. So I gotta ask, are you excited to make your favorite pizza now? The only difference between the first pizza and the second pizza is on the second one here, I decided to put on the Parmesan after the pizza was baked. So now we'll go ahead and cut it up.
So I'm ready to try the salami and cheese. Are you the kind of person that likes to eat the little end first or the crust? I personally like the crust and the cheese. Ooh, that smoked Parmesan is good. Okay, I give it thumbs up, Fogcrawler.
We hope you enjoyed today's webisode. We got excited about the pizza. I hope you guys do too. Please comment and tell me what your favorite toppings are.
Remember, if you like what you saw today, please subscribe. That way you won't miss a single webisode.
I'm Dean the Fogcrawler. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
I'm Joni the Teardrop Nanny. And until the next time, happy trails to you.